Kitchen with Marilyn Smith. I love you, Mary. It's been too long.
I know.
We're making lunch for dinner. Quite frankly, I love lunch for dinner.
I do too, because I'm a sandwich fan.
Me too.
And you know what? If the bread's made with 100% whole grains, it's so good for you. And Dempster's came up with this entire cool line. They ask women what they want. Wasn't that a genius question?
Yes.
Ask us what we want.
Men take note.
Where are you? We want, yeah, we can't
protein.
Say what we want. We want more protein, more fiber, and we want something that has less fat and less sugar
in it. Yes, we do.
And so they create it. They made it really easy. You didn't have to wear your glasses when you go shopping because they're color coordinated. So the turquoise is the one that has, there's only 1.5 grams of fat in a slice and 1 gram of sugar.
Say no to fat and sugar.
And then this was a boost your protein, 11 grams in 2 slices. And this one over here will blow your socks off. You know, I always sign everything peace, love, and fiber.
Yeah.
This has got 12 grams of fiber.
Wow.
In 2 slices, that's like 43% of your fiber.
It's guilt-free bread because it fills you, and you're getting, this one has what, yeah, 11 grams of protein for the two
right,
slices
for the
of
two
bread.
Slices, yes.
That's
yes.
great.
And so this, with triticale and spelt and quinoa and ancient grains, and it's just really such a smart idea, and guilty. It launches today.
Yay!
Ta-da! Okay, so let's make sandwiches.
You matched your plates. I
yes.
appreciate this.
Isn't that good? Look, see, look. Wow! We won't mess anything. Thing up.
Okay,
good. So now you can make one of the three that they've got on their site, Dempster's.ca, but I've got one on mine too.
I should be over turkey by now, but I am not.
This is chicken.
Oh, this is chicken.
Yeah.
So what are we making?
I'm gonna do the turkey one. So you can, yeah. This goes cluck and this goes gobble.
Okay you
good.
Go.
Well we're gonna make a tapenade, but you can make the one with the chicken and the brie and the pear and the this is an onion thing, onion jam and a Dijon.
Recipes will be on our website.
And mine and all over the place, Dempster's.ca too. And then over there's a portobello mushroom with cabbage and sprouts and all that, and we're all over the place. The cameras can't even follow us.
Yeah, no, they can't.
But let's make the tapenade, because I match this, okay?
You did.
I matched. All right. So the tapenade is really neat. So we're adding olives.
Without the pits.
Without the pits, yeah. You want to put them in?
Otherwise, it's a bit too much fiber, if you know what I'm saying. A little bit of grit.
Break your tooth. Okay, that's extra virgin olive oil.
Okay.
And then we got a walnut. We've got some walnuts and some dried cranberries.
By the way, tapenade is a fancy name for crushed up goodness.
Crushed up goodness, it starts with olives. That's basil out of my garden, parsley. Okay, you put
the
balsamic
in. Do you still have basil in your garden?
Yes, I do.
I'm impressed.
I know. Frankie would be so happy for me.
Hang on. Basil, parsley, and
balsamic. And then we're going to put some lemon zest in there.
Okay.
Always wash your lemons before you zest them or you... That's not a good idea.
That was walnuts, Mayor?
That was walnuts in there. I'm a big fan of walnuts, and then I'm going to put this on my thingy.
The lemon zest is a unique little twist to this.
Yes, it adds like a little kind of a sparkly taste.
Fresh.
Okay, you need, yeah, it's really fresh.
A little
zest. So we would do that for a bit longer, and it's going to look like this. Do you want to taste?
Mm.
Do you want to taste this with this?
Guys, that smells
phenomenal.
It's
delicious. Okay, so you're going to make the sandwich. Do you want to make this one?
Oh, that's really good.
Isn't that really amazing? I wish I'd made that recipe up.
I could eat that.
I'm going to tell people I did. Anyway, okay, so you put it on, put some on either side.
Okay,
and you know what? You can make anything you want with a sandwich. This is just new ideas.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm just going to give you a tip. Try to get it to the edge or all the guts in the middle.
Dina, you're doing it wrong. Is that what I'm hearing here?
A little teeny. Okay, that's a lot.
That's too much.
Okay, that's too much. Okay. And then you're going to put leftover turkey. We've got this from, I don't have any leftover turkey from Thanksgiving except for the dregs, so I cooked a turkey breast.
Oh.
So let's put on about 1.5-2 ounces.
By the way, is it too late? I know I'm digressing. To be eating the turkey at this point? Look, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
Bye-bye.
How many days? 3-4?
3-4. Okay. Yeah. Unless your fridge is really, really crowded, maybe only 2 days. Put the goat's cheese on top. I love goat cheese.
Goat's cheese.
Yeah, I love goat's cheese. Well, I love all kind of cheese, but
nice,
that's a good one. Okay, and then we put the romaine on, baby romaine, and you could actually eat this one because I put that all cold, and look, I got a purple knife.
For lunch.
I love being coordinated. Lunch for dinner.
You're impressing me with
and
the colors.
And you know what? I think people think that they're bad parents if they make sandwiches for dinner, and you're not at all. We need to get more whole grains in our diet because it makes you happy.
And
you
it's
produce
a complete
serotonin.
Meal.
Protein. That is totally.
Calcium. How
yes.
many grams of fiber, protein in this?
Protein, well, when you add all that together, oh my gosh, you're stumping me,
I'm
but
sorry.
A ton because there's turkey in there too.
Like at least
you'd get
40.
It. Oh, well, yeah. Maybe in the high 39s.
Okay.
Okay, now this one you can do, you make this one too. So we're going to use leftover chicken. And this is a big tip for, this is onion jam, and then there's some Dijon on top too.
Onion jam?
Onion jam.
Where
or, you
can
use, or you can use chutney. It's harder to find. The chutney's easier to find. But I think a lot of people freak out about when it comes to whole grains is that, you see, whole grains are full of B vitamins.
Okay.
And if you don't get enough in your body, you get really crabby, plus you have really hideous breath. breath. And so you also need, from whole grains, you need to have those healthy things from the whole grains. Plus, you're producing serotonin in your brain, and serotonin in your brain makes you feel good.
It's true.
And you should be feeling good when you're eating this kind of bread because it's so good for you. And it's not what you look like. I always think it's what you feel like.
It's so true.
And if you've got lots and tons of energy, you're going to feel better. Now, put the brie on and a couple of pear slices.
By the way, I could also have this for breakfast. It's so good.
Yeah,
Kevin Frechette was asking, you eat the skin.
It's called the rind, and yeah, you can. Yeah, I mean, unless you're a real, if you don't like, you know, stuff that's got a weird texture, don't.
The pear.
And then we're going to put the pear on. Where's the knife? Here, we'll use this one.
Okay, you
and
do the
so
pear.
Don't do this at home. I'm a trained professional. Don't ever cut towards yourself, but, you know, and we would do a couple of slices of pear. So you're getting kind of a high-end gourmet sandwich on bread that's really healthy for you.
Seriously?
And this, with this grams of fiber, we're getting about 12.7 grams of fiber in this, you know what? Peace, love, and fiber goes to you.
I'm so sad that we've run out of time.
We have?
You had one more sandwich.
We had one more sandwich. Okay, well, let's eat one of them anyway.
Okay, which one? Is this one okay to eat?
Yeah, because I know I had all the stuff in the fridge.
Cheers to good health.
Cheers to good health.
And to fiber and protein. At Marilyn Smith on Twitter. And for all the recipes, breakfasttelevision.ca. Right now for lunch/dinner.
Oh, of course.